Good morning, and welcome to our fall 2022 Dean's Chapel worship experience. I am the Reverend Dr. Candace M. Lewis, and I have the privilege of being the newly appointed chairperson of the Dean's Council, or president of the Dean's Council. And we would like to welcome you to our first of many community worship services. Today's theme for our worship service is When God's People Pray. And if we were going to put a handle on that, we would say, what happens when God's people pray? I think miracles happen when God's people pray. I think we see signs and wonders when God's people pray. People are healed when God's people pray. Prayers are answered when God's people pray. Hearts are mended when God's people pray. Grieving people are comforted when God's people pray. So many amazing things happen when God's people pray. And that is the theme of our worship service today. So we just want to invite you just to be present in this space, whether you're experiencing the service live or if you're experiencing the service virtually. Be present with us and open up your heart to experience a mighty move of God as the Deans leads us forward in this worship experience with a focus, what happens when God's people pray. Our call to worship and opening prayer will come from our very own Dr. Willie Godman, followed by praise and worship by the Turner Theological Seminary seminarians. Thank you.
Thank you, Dean Lewis. Thank you, thank you, thank you, God. Thank you, people of God. Thank you for gathering this space, for the Lord is indeed our God. You know what I'm learning? Is that the closer I get to God, the closer I realize God is to me. But what I'm realizing more and more, that it is necessary for us to come close to the presence of God. Why? Because God has promised that God would be present with us, attend to us, and do all that is necessary for our well-being. So we have come for worship today in this community. The community concerns is that, you know, we are just starting a brand new year, and much is about us, and much to be done. But you know what I've discovered? There's nothing too hard for our God. And so we are gathered in this place. We come for worship, come for prayer, come for learning, come for studying, come for coming together as the people of God, this ITC community. So what am I going to say? Welcome, y'all. Welcome on in the house. Come on into the presence. Come on. Come on and glorify the name of the Lord. If you have within you some means to put your hands together, go ahead and do that. If you have the strength and inclination, come on and do that. Know that God is able. So that as we are gathered in this space and we are welcomed into this worship, we have been called and we do answer this call today. Let us pray. Almighty God, keeper and sustainer of us all, you who never leave nor forsake, you who are always near and never far, you who breathe for and through us, you who hold us in the hollow of your hand, you who keep us and who show us how to live by your power of your spirit, you who guide us in all ways, and so you who adjure us to listen for your call and answer for your word and speak to one another in care and nurturing in ways that are comforting, loving, guiding, and sustaining. Why? Because you do that for us. And so what we're learning, God, if it's not too hard for you, it's not too hard for us. So we come into this space, we come into this worship, gather with as this Dean's Council, gather as the community of ITC, gather as its extended reaches of God. And we are grateful for today. Now to you be glory and honor forever, because that's all we have to give God. And so we thank you now. In the words of our ancestors and elders who taught us always to pray, always to seek your face, and we thank you and we draw their words taught to us. Amen. 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 And then we have learned ashe, 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 oh. Bless God.
Come on, praise the Lord, everybody. Come on, you can do better than that. Praise the Lord, everybody. Now where I'm from, we really don't need no choir because everybody sing for where I'm from. So today, y'all gonna be the choir. And it's a real simple song that says, let the glory of the Lord rise among us. Anybody want God's glory just to rise among us in this place? Come on, put your hands together, say yeah. Oh yeah, yeah. Here we go. Let the glory of the Lord rise among us. Let the glory of the Lord rise among us. Let the praises of our King rise among us. Let it rise. Y'all sound good. Come on, say it. Let the glory of the Lord,
let the glory of the Lord,
let it
rise.
Let the glory
of the Lord,
let it
rise.
Let the praises of our King, let it
rise.
Yeah. Here we go. Everybody say, oh, oh, let it rise. Let it rise. Come on one more time. Say, oh, oh, let it rise. Let it rise. Come on, put your hands together like this, yeah. Come on, let me hear you clap your hands, yeah. Listen, let the songs of the Lord rise among us. Let the songs of the Lord rise among us. Let the praises of our King rise among us. Let it rise. Come on, you got the words, everybody. Let the songs of the Lord,
the songs of the Lord,
let it rise. Let the songs of the Lord make it pleasing to God's ear. Let the praises, let it
rise.
Come on, let's make a big choir. Everybody say, oh. Let it rise.
Let it rise.
Come on, one more time. Say, oh. Oh. Let it rise, let it rise. Yeah, yeah. Come on, we got one. I like this one. It simply says, joy of the Lord rise among us. Let the joy of the Lord rise among us. Let the praises of our King rise among us. Let it rise. Y'all sound real good. Come on. Let the joy of the Lord, let it
rise.
Let the joy of the Lord, cause it feels good. Let the praises, let it
rise.
Whoa. Come on, lift your voice. Everybody say, oh. Let it rise.
Let it rise.
Come on. Say, oh, oh, oh. Somebody say, let it rise. Now come on and put your hands together. Come on and put your hands together. Next song simply says, I'm grateful for everything that God has done. Anybody in here has got a testimony to say, God, I'm grateful. Even during the bad times, I'm grateful. Even during the times when you got to take care of people who don't want to be taken care of, I'm grateful. Even when you're sick, you're grateful. But the song simply says, I am grateful. And I want us to go into a moment of worship where we can just think about all the things that God has done for us during this pandemic. And say, God, you have brought us out. And for that, all we can say is, we're grateful. Song simply says, I am grateful for the things that you have done. Yes, I'm grateful for the victories we've won. I could go on and on and on about your word, because I'm I'm grateful, grateful, so grateful just to praise you, Lord. Say flowing,
flowing from my heart
are the issues. Grateful.
His gratefulness.
Yeah. Come on, hear me say, I am
grateful for the things that you have done.
Yes, I'm
grateful for the victories.
I could
go on and on and on
about your word.
Because I'm grateful just to praise you, Lord.
Everybody say flowing from my heart. Listen, watch this. I love you, Jesus. I worship and adore you. Just want to tell you, Lord, I love you more than anything. And adore you. Just want to tell you, Lord, I love you more than anything. Can we lift that up in this place? Come on, everybody, say,
I love you, Jesus.
Said,
I worship.
Just want to tell you, Lord, I love you.
Lord, I love you
more
than anything.
Oh, come on, say it. Everybody say, I love you.
I love you, Jesus.
I worship and
adore.
I just want to tell you, Lord, I love you.
Lord, I love you more than anything.
Now, for the folks who really love Jesus, I just need you to lift your hands and say, Lord, I love you. Lord, I love you. Lord, I adore you. I worship you. I magnify your name because you have been just that good. Is that anybody's testimony? God, you have been just that good. That even when I wake up in pain, I still love you. Even when people turn their backs on me, I still love you. Even on the brink of losing my mind, I still love you. And that's why we say we're grateful, because you are a God that keeps us. A God that sustains us. And for that, we will always be grateful and we will always love you.
Also are blessed to have Dean Derek Rice with us today, and he is in present and personal, and he is with the Evangelical Lutheran Church of America, and he is going to come and share our scripture with us, the Old Testament reading and the New Testament reading, followed by a solo by Della Davis, God is Able. Amen.
Good morning. My name is Derek Rice. I'm a director of the Lutheran Theological Center of Atlanta here on the campus of ITC. And Mine is the opportunity to lead us in the reading of our scripture for this Dean's Chapel worship service today. Those texts of scripture are Psalms 61, verses 1 through 8, and New Testament reading will come from Mark chapter 11, verses 22 through 25. I'll be reading from a New Revised Standard Version of God's Word, and I invite you to read along. Hear my cry, O God. Listen to my prayer. From the end of the earth, I call you when my heart is faint. Lead me to the rock that is higher than I. For you are my refuge, a strong tower against the enemy. Let me abide in your tent forever. Find refuge under the shelter of your wings. For you, O God, have heard my vows. You have given me the heritage of those who fear your name. Prolong the life of the king. May his years endure to all generations. May the enthroned forever before God appoint steadfast love and faithfulness to watch over him. So I will always sing praises to your name as I pay my vows day after day. Mark chapter 11 reads, Jesus answered them, have faith in God. Truly I tell you, if you say to this mountain, be taken up and thrown into the sea, and if you do not doubt in your heart, but believe that what you say will come to pass, it will be done for you. And so I tell you, whatever you ask for in prayer, believe that you have already received it, and it will be yours. Whenever you stand praying, forgive if you have anything against anyone, so that your Father in heaven may also forgive you and your trespasses. The word of God for the people of God.
God is able. God is able. God is able and he won't fail. God is able. God is able. God. Tell me who can make a mountain move out of my way? Who can make a miracle because of my faith? When the doctor says no, who can still say yes? And when I'm in trouble, who's right there to help me pass every test? God is able. God is able. God is able. Oh, and he won't fail. Tell me who can make a ring out of a little string, and who can help clouds grow back so that the sun can look at me? Who can tell the wind to whistle through the trees? And when I'm in trouble, who's that same God that will come down and rescue me? God is able, God is able, and he won't fail, no, he won't fail, he won't fail, don't you dare give up. able. God is able. Tell you God is able. And he won't. No, God won't. He won't fail. No, God won't. He'll never leave. Never forsake you. No, he won't fail. He'll be there till the end. God won't fail. He won't fail.
Amen, saints. God is able. Come on, somebody say, God is able. God is able and God won't fail. And that's the best segue we needed for Dr. Harold Bennett, the Dean of the Church of God in Christ Incorporated, our longest standing dean. He is now going to come and lead us into a time where we lean into prayers for the people. Come on, Dean Bennett, in your own way, and lead us into a time of prayer with that reminder that God is able.
Oh, glory, glory to God. God is able, and God won't fail. You know what? The word of the Lord said that men and women ought always to pray. That's what the scripture says. And the Lord said, if you ask anything in my name, that's what the Lord said. If you ask anything in my name, the Lord says, that will I do. How many of y'all believe God answers prayer?
Amen.
How many of you know the Lord answers prayer? Hallelujah, hallelujah. You know the Lord answers prayer. I want you to join in this prayer experience, this part of worship today, as we remember the ITC, as we remember our community where we are, as we remember our faculty and administration, and as we remember our churches, you know, the people we are called to serve, our seminarians, those who are joining us via the digital platform kind of space that's there, and those who had an opportunity to come and be a part of the campus ministry. We're going to pray for their wisdom and their strength and their healing and their health, and we're going to ask the Lord to bless them with resources.
Amen.
Thank you, so that they can finish the journey. We're going to ask the Lord to give them the strength that they need. Oh, bless the Lord, so that they can actually have the stick-to-itiveness. Thank you, to get through what it is they got to get through. We're going to ask the Lord to bless the leadership, the administration, the faculty, the staff, the deans of the interdenominational theological center in our various schools. We're going to ask the Lord for healing and for wholeness and for wisdom and for unity. We're going to ask the Lord for a lot of things this morning, for the works of our hands. We're going to ask the Lord, thank you, for funds, for resources. We're going to ask the Lord to bless us with recruitment, and we're going to ask the Lord to smile upon our technology and our instruction and our administration. We're going to ask the Lord to help us again touch the saints, the people that we are sent to serve, the pastors, the churches, the community, the parachurch ministries, and all of the things that the Lord is asking us and the Lord is challenging us. I'm gonna pray this morning. Y'all gonna pray. Y'all gonna join me in prayer. Y'all gonna join me in prayer. Y'all gonna join me in prayer. Come on, Father God, Lord, we love you. God, we love you. God, you our Father. God, you our Mother. God, you are our parent. Oh God, we love you more than anything else. And God, we pray in the name of Jesus, the one who gave us life and the one who is the sustainer. God, that you will meet us in this worship this morning. in this experience this morning. Oh God, in the name of Jesus. Oh God, hear our prayers, oh Lord, as we pray for our seminarians, and God, as we pray for our administration and faculty, and God, as we pray for the community, and God, as we pray for our churches. God, we pray in the name of Jesus that you will anoint like never before. Oh God, in the blessed name of Jesus, we pray that you will pour out your spirit afresh on the ITC. God, help us to hear your voice, Lord. Help us to understand your move. Help us, God, to join hands together, God, and be the seminary, be the saints, be the community, God, that's prepared for theological engagement. Oh God, in the name of Jesus. Oh God, we pray for the students who are coming. In the name of Jesus. God, we pray you'll loose the finances. In the name of Jesus. God, we pray you'll loose the resources. In the name of Jesus. God, the students that are graduating. God, we pray you'll open the pulpits. And God, we pray you'll open the doors. And God, we pray you'll make the placements. God, we pray you'll bring down the high places. And God, we pray you'll make the crooked places straight. In the name of Jesus. God, we pray for our administration. In the name of Jesus. Touch their minds, God. Touch their hearts, oh God. Oh God, in the name of Jesus, continue to guide and lead. Continue to show the way, Lord. Help us, God, to navigate the difficult terrain. In the name of Jesus. Oh God, we pray you'll get involved in the infrastructure here at the ITC. God, continue to touch the technology. Continue to touch the wiring. Continue to touch the computers. Continue to touch the servers. In the name of Jesus. Have your way, Lord. Have your way, Lord. Oh, have your way, Lord. God, we pray this community where we are. Oh, God, we're right across from Vine City. God, we're not far from the bluff. God, we're right over here, Lord, right off the north side. God, we pray your spirit, God, will help this community. Help us, God, to even speak and to see and to sense the needs that are around us. In Jesus' blessed name. In Jesus' blessed name. In Jesus' name. God, in our bodies, as we sit here, Lord. God, we love you, we love you, we love you. Touch, God, in the name of Jesus. God, in the Bible, God, in our communities. God, we rebuke high blood pressure in the name of Jesus. God, we rebuke cancer in the name of Jesus. Lord, we're telling that devil called diabetes, he got to go, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Oh, God, help us, God, to experience your healing power. You know, Lord. Oh, God, you know. Oh, God, you know. Oh, God, you know. Continue to do it, Lord. Continue to do it, Lord. Continue to do it, Lord. Hallelujah. Hey, glory. Thank you. Touch our minds, Lord. Touch our minds, Lord. Help us to think. Help us to hear. Yes, Lord. When it's all said and done, Lord, God, we give you the glory. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. Come on and give the Lord a praise. You're joining us visually. Give the Lord a praise. Right where you are, give the Lord a praise. You're sitting at your table. Lift your hands and say, Lord, I thank you for hearing my prayer. Oh, God, we thank you and we love you. And it is so. It is so. It is so. Our homes are better. It is so. Our school is better. It is so. Our churches are better. It is so. Our bodies are better. It is so. Our communities are better. It is so. Yeah, thank you. God, we love you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. God bless you. God loves you. Hey, hallelujah. Thank you.
Come on, y'all, sing it with me. Because you care in such a special way that my heart and my mind way back on Calvary. That's why I came to lift you up. I magnify. That's why my heart. God is able to do just what he said he would do. He's gonna fulfill every promise to you. Don't give up on God, 'cause he won't give up on you. He's able. Come on, y'all sing it. God is able, just what he said. He's gonna fulfill. Part is easy. It just says, oh, 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 he's able. Come on, you say it. Oh, 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 he's able. Say it again. Oh, oh, oh.
Don't give up on God.
Don't give up on God.
God won't give up on you.
Come on, one more time. Say, don't give up.
Don't give up on God.
'Cause he won't give up on you.
God won't give up on you.
Amen. God is able. Amen. God is able. It's my joy at this time to introduce our preacher of the hour. Her name is Dr. Amy L. Davis. She is a native of the Hattiesburg, Mississippi. And with an enthusiastic, innovative, holistic approach to the worship experience, community outreach, pastoral care for God's people. Dr. Avis is an itinerant elder in the African Methodist Episcopal Church. And Dr. Davis has the privilege of being the 8th president and dean of the Turner Theological Seminary here at the Interdenominational Theological Center. She just finished her term as the Connectional First Vice President of the AME Women in Ministry Conference, and she is a member of the Commission on Chaplains of the AME Church. Dr. Davis is the first woman and Navy chaplain to serve as a president and dean at the Turner Theological Seminary, as well as the ITC. Amen. Let's celebrate. Dr. Davis was commissioned as a chaplain candidate program officer in the United States Navy Reserves way back when dinosaurs roamed the earth in April 2002. In August of 2002, Dr. Davis graduated from the Navy Chaplain School in Newport, Rhode Island, and subsequently she reported to Turner Theological Seminary to begin her journey here at the ITC. On August 12, 2005, Dr. Davis was commissioned for active duty to serve in the United States Navy Chaplain Corps. She had already served 14 and a half years as an enlisted corps person, and she then served 13 and a half years as an officer, a chaplain in the United States Navy. So she came to us with 28 years of military service. Dr. Davis retired from active duty and service in September 2016 as a lieutenant commander in the Navy Chaplain Corps. She earned her Bachelor of Science degree in Business Administration and Human Resource Management from Southern New Hampshire University. She graduated with honors when she was here at the Turner Theological Seminary, and she has recently earned her doctorate or her PhD in her PhD in organizational leadership with an emphasis on ecclesiastical leadership from Regent University. Her life is a testimony and a testimony of the incredible mercy and boundless grace of God through which we all are saved. Faith and persistence are the keys. Reverend Davis's motto, and before I give you her motto, I just want to say personally that Dr. Amy L. Davis, L stands for Lee. Dr. Amy Lee Davis is my friend, and I am honored to have her as a co-laborer in the work of ministry here with the Interdenominational Theological Center. Our president, President Matthew Williams, wanted to be here on today. He expressed his apologies for not being here with us because he had to go to another meeting, but we are honored and will be blessed to have Dr. Amy L. Davis to come and share our message with us on today. Her motto is worship God wholeheartedly, teach God's word effectively, reach out to others creatively, and encourage others continually. And after a song, the next voice you will hear will be that of Dr. Amy Lee Davis. Thank you.
Lord, if I find favor in your sight, Lord, my heart cries, desperately waiting to be where you are. Cross the hardest desert, travel near or far, for your glory do anything just to see you, to behold you as my King. For your glory I will do anything just to see you, to behold you as my King. Lord, if I find favor in your sight, Lord, please hear my heart cry, desperately waiting to be where you are. Across the hardest desert, travel near or far,
to be where you are. Lord, I want to be where you are. Gotta be where you are. Can y'all sing that with me? Wanna be where you are. I gotta be where you are. Wanna be where you are. Sing to the Lord. You are. Come on, sing with your voice. Want to be where you are. Try to be where you are. Gotta be. Want to be where you are.
If you just continue that for your glory, that hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Anything.
Yes. Yes, just to see
just
God.
To behold you. My King, for your glory,
yes,
I will do anything just to see.
Yes, God, yes, God, yes, God.
To behold you as my King.
Oh, hallelujah, together. Hallelujah.
To behold you as the King.
I want to be.
Want to be where you are.
Yes, God. Yes, God.
Gotta be where
you are. Yes, yes, yes. I want to be where you are. Yes, yes, yes. I gotta be. I gotta be where you are. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Is there anybody in the house that just wanna be where God is? Hallelujah. Gotta be where God is. I come at this moment and I just wanna give honor to God, and I praise God for President Matthew Williams in his absence, and just thank God for how God been leading all of us. And then to this colleague of bishops. Let me say bishop. I said bishop deans. You could tell that I hadn't transitioned. I'm about to say something about my pastor, so that's why I said bishop. But to this colleagues of deans, and I, when I look out and I realize, Candace, you know, we're the new one. But then there's a sense of nervousness when you look over and you see your instructors, your professors, and who, so it's two things I'm saying. I'm nervous, and then I'm also saying they old. But they're the same. So I am so excited because I get nervous every time I look, especially with Dr. Godman and Dr. Bennett, when they watch me walk across these, you know, so they like win. So one day I'll be in that shoe that I get to see shoes. I also want to just say honor to my pastor, Pastor Eason. Now, you know, I do confess every time I see him, because he don't see me. I watch him online. So I sent him the message. So I think he's sending me a message that if he can come to church, to that I need to come to church. So I got the message, Pastor. I'll be there next time, okay? You know, so I just wanted to make sure that, you know, I got the message that he just showed up. Yeah. And so to the Turnerites and to the students, Mars Brown students that are here, is worshiping with us. Thank you so much. Y'all keep an eye on him. I know he's not AME, but I may recruit him. But I think he's Kojic. I'm not sure. This young man sitting right here, and then to the Turner Rices in the house, and to all of the ITC seminarians, God bless you, and to faculty, to staff. God has a word. God has a word. Let the words of my mouth, let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in thy sight, O Lord. My Redeemer, my strength, the one who I look to, the captain of my soul. So I come right now, Jesus, asking you to allow your anointing to just flow right now. In Jesus' name, I pray. We're at a very trying time and challenging time at this moment. One of the things that I shared with Dean Candace is how when I was selected as a new president dean for Turner Theological Seminary, I knew the challenges that I would face because Dr. Green did a turnover with me to tell me what things that he was able to address and the things that he was not. And so because of that, one of the things in my transition, I set up a prayer committee. And in that prayer committee, we begin to just go before God. Every Monday, we are on the prayer line together. And I present to them a list. We started it for Lent season, and we're still doing it. And so here we are at times where most of us have had the experience with what we all call Murphy's Law. The idea that if anything can go wrong, it will. There are many applications of it. For instance, if you try to fix something, you find yourself looking at something else that's broken. Murphy's Law says it will take longer than you anticipated. It will cost you more than you expected. It will break down before it is paid for. But someone will not always understand that even in Murphy's Law that we should be some praying saints. And we have come to such a circumstances that for this moment that God directed me to chapter 4 of the book of Nehemiah. Here Nehemiah faced severe and violent opposition to his work of rebuilding the wall and the gates of Jerusalem. Listen to these words in Nehemiah, the 4th chapter, and the English Standard Version says, "Now when Sanballat heard that we were rebuilding the wall, he was angry and greatly enraged. He jeered at the Jews. And he said in the presence of his brothers and of the army of the Samaria, 'What are these feeble Jews doing? Will they restore it for themselves? Will they sacrifice? Will they finish up in a day? Will they revive the stones out of the heap of rubbish and burn ones at that?' Tobiah the Ammonite was beside him and said, 'Yes, what they are building, if a fox go up on it, it will break down their stones.'" And then if we drop down to verse 9, it says, "And we prayed to our God and set a guard as a protection against them day and night." We prayed. So just for a little while, I just want to say to us in this ITC community, Just pray and let God fight your battles. We have come looking at the circumstances that are outlined in Nehemiah. We see as is outlined in the text, the rebuilding and the restructuring pictures for us to step to a recovery stage for ourselves here in our own community. We walk around and we see areas of damage and ruin in our own space where we walk in. We have work to do. We have work to do at Turner. We have work to do at Gammon. We have work to do at C.H. Mason. We have work to do at Phillip. We have work to do at Morehouse. We have work to do. And somebody is asking the question, will they sacrifice it? Will they finish it? And I stopped by this morning, this afternoon, to tell you, we must be like Nehemiah when they said, we prayed. We prayed. And if we take a moment as a community of believers and decide to what? Pray. Because the Bible tells me that the prayers of the righteous, the Bible tells me that those who labor before God, heaven would open up. When we pray before God and we allow God to lead us in the rebuilding. See, some of us want to do it all by ourselves, and we need to move egos out the way. We need to come together as a community of believers and to decide that whatever it is that we need of, we need to come together and pray. Lay it before God so that God can do the work and God can get the glory. And so we have to ask ourselves the question, as a community, are we not coming together because we want to see who gets the glory? Are we not coming together because we have the wrong attitude, feelings of bitterness, feelings of resentment? We cannot rebuild together. We cannot turn it around together until we come on one accord. And until we come on one accord, that's called bringing God in the midst of our damaged lives. We got to call it for what it is. We have to stop walking around like we have blinders on us. Many of us are preachers of the gospel. Many of us are leading people in communities, and we need to understand, in order for us to get from here to there, we must have a plan. And Dr. Bennett, you know in the military that you can't defeat the enemy without a plan. You know you can't show up and one unit is going over here and another unit is going over there. You will not get the mission completed. See, the one of the things that I love about the 28 years that I was in the military, we may not like each other, but we had a common goal to get the job done. We may not know each other. We may not know the background. We may not know where you come from. But when we show up to work, it's like Nehemiah coming with a plan to rebuild. And when we come in, we stand in what we call formation. And we get the instructions from the top. And it's made clear in the direction that we are going. And so if we are going to rebuild, we can answer the question, will they restore it? Yes. Will they sacrifice? Yes. Will they finish it? Yes. Will they revive it? Yes. So we come reflecting on the need to respond to the opportunity to answer the question, could we recover? Could we restore? Could we rebuild? We come today and say, yes, we can. Here, Nehemiah, he carefully surveyed the walls and the gates to see how much work he had to do.
If we're going to pray about it, we need to know. We need to know what it is that we must do. Dean Candace, I need to know what it is that Gammon is trying to do. I need to know what C.H. Mason is trying to do. If we all come together and allow God to unify us. Here we see the first note of the meeting with the enemies who later opposed Nehemiah. They observed what was going on. And they questioned what they see, what they saw. See, in chapter 14, we talked about that Murphy Law comes into operation. The opposition takes off his gloves and the real battle begins. We, like Nehemiah, have an enemy who opposes us and who is very crafty and powerful. But we have seen the work and we have seen the destruction around us. But we have to come with the mind to work together and to build. We have to come with the mind to say we pray to our God. And then we set a guard as a protection for everything that's going to come against us. I don't want your holy self to act like somebody going to just sit there and let you restore something to God's glory. I don't want your holy self to act like the enemy don't want to see ITC restored. I don't want your holy self to think that the enemy is not going to knock you all upside the head. But I need you to understand about that old hymn by Martin Luther when he said, "A mighty fortress is our God. The bulwark never failed, and a helper and aim, the floods of mortar hills prevailing." God's truth abided, still his kingdom is forever. Against everything, I'm calling the deans, I'm calling the president of ITC, I'm calling the faculty, I'm calling the family and friends, I'm calling the students to just pray. Pray against every effort that is coming against us to live in harmony. Pray against every effort that we can't live together in community. Pray that we can recover from all the damage and the hurt and the ruins. Pray so when the enemy shows up again, we need to pray. Because the enemy is using damaged buildings. The enemy is using hurt feelings. The enemy is using ruined relationships. The enemy is using people's grief. The enemy is using that to keep us down. Almost invariably, the enemy first step is to halt such a recovery just like this. How would they do it? The enemy will come and discourage us and then divide us and ridicule us and allow us to feel rejected. But I stop by here to tell you there's a healing power that's on this side of heaven. There's a healing power that will restore us. There's a healing power that will rebuild ITC. But we must pray and call on the power of the living God to move us in the right direction. Let us walk together. Let us sing together. Let us rejoice together. Is there anybody who is ready to rebuild? When Sanballat heard that they were rebuilding the walls, the Bible said he became angry and greatly incensed. He ridiculed the people who lived there. I hope this sounds familiar. Somebody got angry. They began to ridicule. They began to try to bring division in the presence of God's people. Here we find that they asked the question, "What are these feeble Jews doing?" Hallelujah. I don't know about you, deans, but every time I step out, somebody asking me, "Are you gonna stay at the ITC?" Every time I step out, somebody wanna ask me, "Do I have a plan B?"
Every time I step out, somebody want to ask me, am I going to survive? But I stop by here to tell you, don't ask me, ask God, because God sent me here. And if God sent me here, God didn't bring me this far to turn me around. So I stop by here to tell you, every teacher, every faculty, every student, every seminary, God didn't bring you this far to break turn around on you. So you need to put these Sanballat's comments in the grave, because God is doing a mighty thing. Tobiah the Ammonite said, what are they building? We have to come and speak power for ourselves. We have to come, and as we are praying, what are they doing at ITC? Oh, I saw your sign. It says it's a school of prophets. So that means that God is in the house. It said that there are leaders who are being trained to be prophetic problems. That means it is centered around God. We say that we are here as a spirit of community. So in other words, what are they doing at the ITC?
Yes, 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 yes.
They are God's people.
Yes, yes.
God's people.
Yes.
As my newest student, when I recruited her, I said, you will get no other experience like at the ITC. Where else could you go and be in community? Where else could you go and begin to see yourself and see people who look like you? Where else could you go and see people who can preach like you? Where else could you go? I love my experience at the ITC. Why? Because I love having a good debate in Ellison class with my Baptist brothers, with my Presbyterian sisters. I love the ITC because I believe in what I believe. Leave it, and the ITC let your voice go forth. Where else? Where else would your voice be heard at African Methodism? Where else could your voice be heard as Kojic? Where else could your voice be heard as Baptist? Where else could your voice be heard as United Methodist? Where else? But the ITC. And so here we find that they were on an attack, because really what we should see in the text, why did Sanballat show up in the first place? We need to understand that the enemy only shows up when they see God's hand moving. The enemy, If the enemy didn't see the hand of God, and that ITC is going to be that premier institution, if ITC in the collaboration of the deans of the denomination, if the enemy didn't see it, wouldn't bother with you. So we have to look at what is happening in this text. So they came, when you get to verse 6, it says, so we rebuilt the wall. And all the wall was joined together to half of its height. For the people, what? Had a mind to work. I don't know about you, but I didn't leave where I was at. And I didn't come here with a mind to work. I showed up at the ITC because what? I remember when I sat in the classroom, Dr. Garman, when you made me look at myself, when you made me understand who am I and what issues I bring to the table and what issues I need to take off the table. So here I came with a mind to work so that we can rebuild what? Together. I know we have challenges, but we need to put in the grave the ridicule, the sarcasm. We need to that can destroy the confidence, not only of our students, but the faculty and the leaders here and the president. We need to put it to the side and let God fight our battles.
we find ourselves that we must understand that the enemy knows how to mobilize his forces. The enemy knows how to escalate the attack. The enemy knows how to plan a direct attack on your spirit, your mind, your body, and everything. So when you begin to pray, and then you are praying with a brother or a sister, when we begin to pray as a community, when you begin to pray, the move of God will begin to transform our very existence. When we begin to pray, we begin to see life gets better here at the ITC. When we begin to pray, we will put the enemy on his tracks and that they will leave us alone. When we begin to pray. Have you ever faced something so bad that you forgot to pray? You were focusing on the situation and rather than God. Were you ever threatened? Your peace ever been threatened? If I'm going to keep my job, lose my job, or get my job back. Have you ever been threatened by the enemy of your soul? But when God's people pray, I need you to understand that a new spirit will invade the hearts of God's people. The Holy Spirit would light a fire that could not be quenched. When God's people pray, it will begin to feel like fire shut up in your bones. When God's people pray, the fire burning in your heart so that you can experience the power of God's mercy. When God's people pray, you are invoking the power of the living God. And you say, God, I need you to show up. And I need you to fight this battle for me. I need you to show up, God, because the enemy looks like he's winning. I need you to show up, God, because I feel like that I'm all by myself. I need you to show up, God, because I realize that, God, with you are my help. I need you to show up, God, because you said that when I look unto the hill, my help should come. I need you to show up, God. I need you to show up and fight the battle for me. I need you to remind me day by day all things are possible. I need you to show up, God. I need you to show up for the children of God. And I need us to walk in your abundance. I need you to walk in your confidence. I need you to show up, God, because you said there is nothing too hard for you. I need you to show up, God, because I need you to bring my brothers. I need you to bring my sisters so that we can pray together for your power from on high to come. Because if we can pray together, we will tap into the source of our strength. Yes. I need you to show up, God, for your power, yes, to be revealed. Yes. I need you to show up. Just like you reveal your power when Jesus died on the cross. Oh, death, where is thy sting? Oh, grave, where is thy victory? The dynamic power of God has the ability to restore. The dynamic power of God has the ability to transform. The dynamic power of God has the ability to rebuild. And we have to tap into that power. We need to move aside egos. We need to move aside differences. We need to move aside hurt feelings. We need to come together in the dynamic power of God into the perfect will of God. If God is recorded as parting the Red Sea, then when we pray and let God fight the battles, what do you think he can do here at the ITC? If it's recorded that God fed 5,000, remember what God can do for you. But we just have to pray and still stand for God to fight the battle. If it's recorded that God brought you this far, and the word says he will never leave you nor forsake you. It is recorded that the word says that his children, the righteousness, would never beg for bread. So we must remember, if we just pray and let God fight the battle, prayer would allow us to walk in God's power together. Prayer would allow us to move in unity together. Prayer would allow us to accomplish everything we need together. In other words, if we just learn how to pray together, restoration will take place. Restored faith will come. Restored strength, restored confidence, a restored mind, and restored relationships. If we just learn how to pray together, everything we need, God has his hand already on it. Everything we need, it will be released to us. But we must be mindful that every now and then, we need to see ourselves as Sanballat in the way of God. All power, praise God in power. All power, live like you have it. All power, walk in your divine anointing. All power, just pray and allow God to fight the battle. If that's you, if you stand up all over in the chapel. In Nehemiah, they said the work was extensive and it spread out. And they were widely separated from each other. But we are here together. But they said when the trumpet sound, the Bible said when they hear the trumpet sound, they said, join us there. The trumpet is sounding. The trumpet is sounding. And it's time for us, not Gammon alone, not C.H. Mason alone, not Turner alone, not Richardson Fellowship alone. It's time for us. Who is us? The executive team, faculty, administrators, students, deans, community. It's time for what? Us to join together. If we just learn to pray together. Am I doing it? Hallelujah.
Pray for you.
If we can join closer.
You pray for me.
If we can come closer together.
And watch God change things.
If we can come closer. If we can come closer. Man, I said, they said, when the trumpet sound, the trumpet is sounding, and we just come. So we can take this area, take this area. I just want us to move together.
And watch God change things.
We all have our own experiences, right? And we need to call out. We need to call out to God.
You pray.
What is it? Because our experiences are what? Different, right?
And watch God change.
What is it that you want to watch God do? Here at the ITC. What is it that you want to see God do? Let's take
you pray
less than a minute. And let's call it out for ourselves.
Watch God change.
Hallelujah. Start calling it out from your soul. Start calling it out. Resources, call it out. Students, call it out. Restored building. Healing. Hallelujah. Oh, yes. Hallelujah. You calling it out. We are putting it in the atmosphere now.
You
hallelujah. Hallelujah. Abundance. Hallelujah. Glory. Let your glory. Hallelujah. Yes, yes. Call it out. Let it fall. Let it fall before God's feet. Call it out.
You pray for me.
Hallelujah.